Desmond's Flicks is made possible by the incredible support from the Patreon community. If you'd like to help support the channel and keep it going, consider becoming a Patreon today. Link is in the description below. Plus, you'll gain access to awesome perks. Now, let's get into the video. Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers, was released in 1988 and was directed by Dwight H. Little. The film stars Donald Pleasance, Ellie Cornell, Daniel Harris, and George P. Wilbur. The fourth installment in the Halloween franchise sees Michael Myers returning to Haddonfield to kill his niece Jamie Lloyd, daughter of Laurie Strode. Halloween 4 was originally a ghost story, but because of the poor reception to Halloween 3, Season of the Witch, Michael Myers was reintroduced into the franchise. Halloween 4 went on to gross $17.8 million at the box office on a budget of $5 million. Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers also begins the Thorn Trilogy, which is continued in Halloween 5, The Revenge of Michael Myers, and Halloween, The Curse of Michael Myers. Now, let's get into the plot breakdown. As usual, full spoilers ahead. October 30th, 1988, Michael Myers has been comatose for 10 years since the events of Halloween 2. He's transferred to Smith's Grove Sanitarium from Ridgemont Federal Sanitarium. En route in an ambulance, Michael awakens and kills everyone after hearing that he has a niece, which causes the ambulance to crash into a river. Samuel Loomis, Michael's former psychiatrist, learns of his escape and begins looking for him. Loomis goes to a gas station where Michael killed both a mechanic and a clerk. Michael and Loomis have a brief standoff before Michael escapes in a tow truck, smashing into the gas pumps, causing them to explode, destroying Loomis's car and disabling the phone lines. Loomis then hitches a ride to Haddonfield to pursue Michael. Jamie Lloyd is living in Haddonfield with her foster family, the Carruthers, along with their teen daughter, Rachel. Jamie knows about Michael, but she doesn't realize he's the man in her nightmares. Richard and Darlene Carruthers have a Halloween party to attend and leave Rachel to babysit Jamie, which leads her to canceling her date with her boyfriend Brady. Rachel takes Jamie to buy ice cream and a Halloween costume after school. Michael arrives in town and steals a mask at the same time Jamie and Rachel are at the store, taking a swipe at Jamie. Thinking she got scared of the Halloween masks, Rachel and Jamie quickly leave the store. Later that night, Michael breaks into the Carruthers' house and discovers photos of Lori in Jamie's bedroom, while Rachel takes Jamie trick-or-treating. Michael then goes to the power station and kills poor old Bucky by yeeting him into a transformer, which plunges the town into darkness. Meanwhile, Loomis arrives in Haddonfield and warns Sheriff Ben Meeker that Michael has returned. While the sheriff and Loomis are looking for Jamie and Rachel, Michael attacks the police station, killing all of the officers. A mob forms to kill Michael when Loomis reveals Michael has returned. Rachel stumbles upon Brady cheating on her with Meeker's daughter Kelly and loses sight of Jamie. After being stalked by Michael, Rachel finds Jamie. Sheriff Meeker and Loomis arrive at the sheriff's house after they find Jamie and Rachel and interrupt Brady and Kelly. They then barricade the house while Loomis leaves to look for Michael at the Carruthers' house. Sheriff Meeker heads out to deal with the mob and hands over the responsibility of staying by the radio to Rachel. Michael, who snuck into the house earlier, savagely kills both the deputy and Kelly. After discovering the bodies, Rachel and Brady realize they're trapped in the house. Rachel finds Jamie and flees to the attic, while Brady attempts to fend off Michael, but ends up getting his skull crushed. Rachel and Jamie climb through a window onto the roof. Jamie is safely lowered down, but Rachel is pushed from the roof by Michael and knocked unconscious. Jamie runs down the street and finds Loomis, who then takes shelter in the school. Michael, now with blonde hair, teleports and throws Loomis through a glass door, then chases Jamie through the school. Before Michael is able to kill Jamie, Rachel uses a fire extinguisher against him, which leads to Michael vanishing. After hearing the alarm go off, the mob arrives at the school. The mob members quickly leave with Jamie and Rachel and take the girls to the next town. A trooper tells them about a substation up the road, but Michael has been hiding underneath the truck. He climbs into the back of the truck and kills the two men in the bed, and then tears Earl's neck open. Rachel then pushes Earl's body out to take control of the truck while attempting to throw Michael off. She succeeds and then rams him with the truck, which sends him flying into a ditch near an abandoned mine. Sheriff Meeker, Loomis, the remaining mob, along with the state police, arrive. Rachel leaves the truck with Jamie inside, but Jamie leaves to touch Michael's hand, which leads to him rising. Sheriff Meeker, along with the state police and the mob, unload on Michael until he falls down the mine. Loomis and Sheriff Meeker take the girls home, where Darlene goes upstairs to get a bath ready for Jamie, but she's suddenly attacked. Loomis goes to see what happened and finds Jamie holding a pair of bloody scissors at the top of the stairs, completely emotionless. Loomis screams and tries to shoot Jamie, but Sheriff Meeker stops him. Loomis falls to the floor sobbing as Rachel, Richard, and Meeker stare at Jamie in horror as the credits roll. Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers, is one of those dependable 80s slashers. And that's not to demean slasher films. I love slashers. One of the draws to slashers, at least to me, is the predictability. So when a dude gets a thumb to the forehead, or a gnarly throat rip, or skull crunching in Brady's death, all those aspects always get a cheer out of me. Yeah, I know it sounds sick, but there's something so fun about the inventive ways Michael takes out his victims. I've always really dug how vicious Michael is in this film. I love George P. Wilbur as the Shape, his size and stature is imposing next to any of the cast. I also love Ellie Cornell and Daniel Harris. During the climax of the film, Rachel is doing everything she can to protect Jamie, and the acting between the two felt authentic. That to me is another strong aspect to the film that I feel sets it apart from others in the franchise. The opening credits are another aspect I love about this film. It's simplistic, but it firmly establishes that this is a return to the Michael Myers saga with its foreboding mood. The scale of the film also feels larger. We now have the town included with mobs forming to take down Myers. We also get to see the full extent of Michael's powers with the police station massacre, which I gotta say, I wish we could have seen that in the film. Lastly, I love the ending with Jamie taking up the mantle from Michael. Unfortunately, that was all thrown away in the next film. Despite that, I still love this ending. With all that said, I'm going to give Halloween 4, The Return of Michael Myers, and add to the collection. This to me is one of those dependable 80s slashers. It's always a great way to kick off October with its strong fall vibes. The characters of Rachel and Jamie are memorable, and George P. Wilbur's performance as Myers is one of my favorites of the franchise. Yeah, the mask isn't the best, and I really wish they could have had the original mask, like shown on the cover, but at least we have a suitably savage Myers with some pretty creative kills and some decent practical effects. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And if you'd like to support the channel even more, become a Patreon today. Link is in the description below. Thank you so much for coming by, and I'll see you guys on the next video.